What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today, I'm going to show you some new features in Inkscape 2.5 for schedule. Let's get started. Number one is the updated material editor. The new material editor now has a list of all the materials in the scene. So you can easily select a material by finding them in the list and clicking on a material. Or you can also search a specific material by typing in this box here. Number two, clear coat material. Just select a material that you want and switch the type to clear coat. As you can see, creating a car material can now be done with just one click. And you can easily change the color here as well. You can use the color presets or you can use the advanced tab to create custom colors. As you can see, this material is great for materials such as car paint and shiny metals. Number three, adjustable grass. This was available in the previous version of Inkscape, but I haven't covered it yet. When using grass material, you can now customize it more using the grass settings such as height and height variation. There we go. Now you can create better looking grass in Inkscape. You can also use these settings to create firm material as well. Number four, new horizon presets. In version 2.5, there is a new horizon preset, mountain. Also, the horizon presets for urban and white cubes have been updated and now look a lot better than in the previous version. Number 5. Asset Library. The Inkscape Asset Library has been updated and expanded. It is now web-based to keep your download time low. They have also added 150 new assets, so now there are more than 340 models in total. The categories include accessories, furniture, people, vegetation, and vehicles. You can easily search through the models using the new search tags located here. The model will come in as a proxy, but it will render perfectly in Inkscape. After importing, you can position, rotate, and scale the model as you like. Some of the new models are from EverMotion, which have a higher level of details. As you can see, the asset library is a great way to populate your scene quickly and easily. Since these are proxies, you can add a lot of assets to your model without slowing down your scene. Number 6. Contrast control. The contrast settings have also been updated. It now has separate parameters for highlights and shadow, so you can have better control over your image. Number 7. Shadow Sharpness. In the Atmosphere tab, go down to the Sky Orb section. There is a new parameter that lets you customize your shadows. Sliding it to the left will make your shadow softer. Sliding it to the right will make your shadow sharper. Number 8. Improved Fog. The fog settings also has been updated. Now when you use fog, you have the option to adjust the fog height. This allows more customization so that you can use it to create different moods for your scene. Number 9. Updated Video Editor. The video editor now has a slider to adjust the total duration of the clip, and the auto camera path is now smoother, which makes your video creation even faster. Number 10. Web Standalone. This was also available in the previous version of Inkscape, but I haven't mentioned it in my previous video yet. you can export a web standalone by using this button here. After it's done uploading, your browser will open. Once the server has finished processing the data, your scene will be loaded and it will automatically display your project from the same position that was showing in the Inkscape window. Then you can navigate using the arrow keys and your mouse. This is a new feature, so there are still some limitations, and there are less settings here than in the AXE standalone. But this is still very useful for sharing your projects with your teammates and clients. Number 11. Improved reflection. In the new version of Inkscape, reflection has been improved. When using Inkscape at ultra quality, Inkscape will now render texture objects more accurately in reflections. So even if part of the object is behind the camera, the texture will still show up correctly in the reflection. And that's all for today, guys. Those are the new features in Inkscape for SketchUp. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, comment below if you have any questions. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.